For now, we have one guest in our studio, and we will switch to him, and he can introduce himself and tell you why he's here and what he's doing and how he's connected to the Predator Tour. I say welcome and good afternoon, Hans. You're live at the broadcast now.
Thank you, Evert. Well, like always, I'm in the background running the app. Running the catches and the pictures and all that kind of stuff. Some people might know me from BFT Shop, a web shop selling most exclusively the Swedish brands like Strike Pro, BFT, former Spig, The Pig, all that kind of very nice fish catching machines. And always helping Evert running the tournament, and hopefully it runs smoothly for you guys. And well, let's see what the catches are for today.
You've been here from 7 this morning.
7 o'clock, yeah. First coffee. First coffee, like always.
The catches, how's it going?
Yeah, well, in the morning there was like in 5 or 10 minutes the first pike was
there. No, 8 and 9 minutes.
8 and 9 minutes? You saw it? Okay. Well, yeah. In a very short time. And well, if you look at the leaderboard now, there's some big pikes being caught already.
114
something. That's very nice to see that on the picture and get them in. Yeah. And yeah, they're certainly coming on the pictures. We see some teams struggling to get pikes, some teams struggling to get perch.
And most of them struggling to get perch.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Sender is going quite well.
Sender was one of the most caught fish, I think, in the tournament so far. Yeah.
And what do you exactly do? I know what you do, but
for the viewers. Yeah. Well, the participants take a picture from the app. Mm-hmm. We get it in here. We check it if there's correct. The QR code is in the screen. Of course, we support them. If there's anything wrong, they can contact us via what kind of channel there is, telephone, WhatsApp. Yeah. Well, you saw them coming in.
Okay.
Give them the QR code, check the picture, and put it in on the leaderboard.
Yeah.
And sometimes they send in crazy pictures like holding the pike and with the QR code, no leaderboard use or no measure board. That's cool.
And can you amend that? Can you change that? Can you correct them? Or do you, like I saw one send a picture of, I think, at least a meter pike, and you put in on the leaderboard 11 centimeters?
Yeah.
Just to
get a trigger from them, from hey, why is my pike just 11 centimeters and not 1 meter?
So. The only way to have them learn.
Yeah.
Guys, can I do a short interruption? I've got a question. Yeah, sorry again. I got a question from Roel van der Hoeven, and I think Hans can explain it also. What does the icon colors mean on the leaderboard? Can you explain it to Hans?
Yeah, you have golden, bronze and silver, or golden, silver, bronze in the correct order. Gold, you have the biggest fish from that category. So you have three categories, pike, zander, perch. And I'm not sure if you can see my telephone screen from the yeah, okay. In the top one, you can see a bronze at the pike, so it should be that this pike is the third biggest pike in the tournament. On number two, team 9 has a gold one, so I think they have the biggest pike. That should be the 114 pike I checked in earlier, and it is. So, and that's why they're golden. They have the biggest pike of the tournament for now. If the second icon has a different color, then it means the zander, and the third icon, that means the perch. So in that way you can find very quickly the biggest fish on the leaderboard. There's also a button here, and you can ask for the top catches. I'll open it for you guys, and then you see the biggest three fish of the tournament.
Yeah. Well, you saw the telephone of Hans. It's not really clear because that's because of the green screen. Because we use the green screen in the back. As you see, I'm in the water, close for the start. So, but if you go to your own free web app, free in the App Store and Google Play Store, and you can check it out. And I hope, Roel, that your question is answered. And you're also answering a question that do you sell measure boards and stickers? No, we don't. This is exclusive for the participants of the Predator Tour. Okay, and then we go back to win now.
How strict are you? I see what you do,
yeah,
and I see some pictures of which I think, well, you're in a competition, why do you send this picture?
Yeah, well,
holding a pike.
Yeah, we're always quite strict, but there has to be a fun factor also, of course. And like you saw, we got in a picture that's actually, we could decline it, but we found the measure board, we could find the scale, and we could measure the fish.
You checked it here, you measured it.
Yeah, I picked downstairs. The board from downstairs and, looked, okay, it's 80, and then I can count the rest. Yeah. So, yeah, we're quite strict, but I
it's
think...
fun as well.
Yeah.
Why did you decide to do this?
Well, the big guy asked me to.
The big guy. Oh, that's him.
Yeah. Who can
guilty,
say no?
Yeah. Guilty as charged. Guilty as charged.
Well, I'm a fisherman also, so I like it, but also quite an IT guy.
Yeah.
And Evert asked me to, hey, can you support me with the GPS, the IT, the app?
Yeah.
Give input, give comments. Yeah. Cool to do so. And the first time we were just with two computers with Evert's son, and that was it.
Yeah.
Then the second one came, then the GPS system, then the app, now the green screens and the cameras. Yeah, very cool to do.
Kind of better.
Yeah.
What do you expect? You know, I ask these questions constantly. What do you expect from this in the future? The combination of a normal competition with live feeds, etc.
Yeah, I think this is way ahead in what we did it's not just one step ahead, it's like 10 steps now, or a big jump.
Yeah.
Normally we have pictures, we have a live comment, send it to the guys, but now it's really live.
Yeah.
And the next step would be cameramen on the boat, on several boats, on some boats, but that's very cool.
Yeah, and the chopper.
The chopper, yeah, there was some experience. Yeah, that was cool.
Tell me more about BFT.
Well, BFT as such is a Swedish brand from Catch with Care.
Mm-hmm.
And like 10 or 11 years ago, I got to Evert, said, hey, I would like to start up a web shop.
Yeah.
Perhaps a store in future. Well, that's 10 years ago, so the store, I'm not sure. And then we were discussing about the name.
Yeah.
And we come up with a BFT shop. So, and that started. Big Fish Tackle. Big Fish Tackle.
So, your main clients and customers are the fishermen that want to catch big fish.
Yeah, if you want to catch big fish, you need this tackle. Yeah.
That's you have for sure. You're the go-to.
Okay.
Do you have any advice for the fishermen at this moment? From
well, that's quite difficult because they're all over Europe. So
yeah.
And I'm not even a boat owner, so I'm the lucky guy who sometimes have to fish with or may fish with Evert or some other guys.
Yeah.
But that's quite local in Holland. But you see where the pictures are coming from.
Yeah.
Keep on hammering. Keep on fishing.
And how about the Latvia and Estonian?
Yeah, that's quite interesting to see. They're big pikes. They just need a few more perches.
They cannot fish for them. That's
Well, they have big ones, like around 40, I thought to see. Yeah. So, I think they have a quite steady place already.
And the distance with the first two and the third is quite big, almost 200 points.
Yeah, but on the other hand, the number three already has his three perch. Just missing one or two zanders. So
we've got more, 2 days more.
Yeah, it's still 2 days fishing, so. Okay. And we had a discussion about the fishing. It could be that some guys now go for the zanders and the perches, and tomorrow go to another place and only go for the big
that's
pikes.
That's the advantage of this way.
Yeah,
of competition.
I think that's a very cool way of fishing.
Yeah.
You can make a really tactic. Okay, this water is very good for perch and zanders. We go there. Tomorrow we go over there for the pike. Even the weather could change, and that could make it be a decision maker. So.
Yeah. Do you think about the advantages some people have in their countries? Or is it like me, I think, they're fishing for fun and honor?
Yeah, well, you have local knowledge, so you have an advantage. Yeah. But in this way, all the participants have the same advantage. It's your local water.
Yeah.
But I think Evert has a call this morning from some German guys who are fishing in Holland.
Friesland.
They're in Friesland, so local waters, perhaps they're quite near the border, but that's also something that's
happening. Tomorrow they'll come back.
They go back and go to Rügen and catch some very big pikes.
Yeah, true. Maybe later on I would like to you to show what you do on your laptop.
Yeah, sure.
I think then we'll use Brad's camera.
Yeah, then we can walk around.
We'll
collect some pictures before and then show what's happening.
Makes it more easy to understand how the leaderboard is being uploaded. And thanks for this conversation.
Thank you, guys.